Hey, I'm Matt, and I'm really thankful that you would take this part of your day to spend with us. As we begin today, we're coming on the heels of months of a global shutdown. We've been in the middle of a pandemic, and we're just beginning to feel the effects of it. And so when we are in the middle of confusion and chaos, where we've watched the world come to a stop, it seems fitting that today we begin declaring an essential truth that our God cannot be stopped. So in the next few moments, whatever's going on around you, would you focus in on the God who loves you, who made you and is for you, and who's never stopped loving you, pursuing you, who's never against you. He's the one who is continuing to be at work even when everything around us is in confusion. And so we cling to him as our one who's certain, as our certain foundation. And let's rejoice together and declare this truth that God, you cannot be stopped. And for that, we are so thankful. So let's sing together.
The dark tried to hide you and steal you away. Death tried to keep you inside of the grave. The enemy fought you, he tried but he lost. You cannot be stopped. When we cried for freedom, you tore down the walls. The weight of our burdens, you carried it all. Our fears and our failures hang dead on the cross. You cannot be stopped. Our God, we stand on your victory and shout out your praise. Miracle maker, you're mighty to save. Awesome power, relentless in love. Stopped. Mover of mountains, breaker of chains, Jesus' triumph over the grave. Sing hallelujah, the battle is won, nothing can stand against our God. There's nothing that can stop our God. There's nothing that can stop our God. There's nothing that can stop our God. There is nothing. There is nothing. There's nothing that can stop our God. There's nothing that can stop our God. There's nothing that can stop our God. There is nothing. There is nothing.
He cannot be stopped.
There's nothing that can stop our God.
He cannot be stopped.
There's nothing that can stop our God. There's nothing that can stop our God. There is nothing. There is nothing. Mover of mountains, breaker.
Mighty
So thankful that God cannot be stopped, and also that our God is the Good Shepherd. And as we were singing this, I was thinking about how Jesus calls himself the Good Shepherd. And did you know that some of the earliest artwork that we've been able to find of who Jesus is and how he's depicted in history is Jesus as the shepherd? In the Roman catacombs, there are images of Jesus as the shepherd carrying sheep on his shoulder. And I was thinking about this and thinking of Jesus saying this in John chapter 10, where he says, "I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd lays down his life for the sheep. The hired hand is not the shepherd and does not own the sheep. So when he sees the wolf coming, he abandons the sheep and runs away. Then the wolf attacks the flock and scatters it. The man runs away because it's a hired hand and cares nothing for the sheep. I am the good shepherd. I know my sheep and my sheep know me. Just as the Father knows me and I know the Father, and I lay down my life for the sheep. I have other sheep that are not of this sheep pen. I must bring them also. They too will listen to my voice, and there shall be one flock and one shepherd. The reason my Father loves me is that I lay down my life only to take it up again. No one takes it from me, but I lay it down of my own accord. I have authority to lay it down and authority to take it up again. This command I received from my Father." Jesus, the good shepherd, knows you because he's not a hired hand. He's the one with all authority that's been given to him. And as the shepherd who knows you, he does not ever leave you or run from you. And when the wolf comes, he doesn't leave you alone. You see, this incredibly comforting picture of Jesus as the good shepherd is not just comforting because it's this analogy. It's comforting because he is the one that has the authority to lay his life down for you and had the authority to take it back up. And Jesus, with all authority and all love, is passionate about you, his sheep. And the beautiful thing is that he says, when he speaks, we hear his voice and we know him. And we know his voice because he knows us and he's made us to know him. And so we are in this flock with him and he's bringing people from everywhere into his fold, into his pen. And he's the good shepherd, the one we can trust, the one that we can find our comfort and hope, the one in whom we are protected. And so when we have confusion and chaos all around, would you come back to this center where we see Jesus, the good shepherd? He's the one who's steadfast and sure. He's the one that we can find our protection in. And even Jesus, in saying this in John chapter 10, is actually connecting to what God said in Ezekiel in the Old Testament. "For this is what the sovereign Lord says, I myself will search for my sheep and look after them. As a shepherd looks after his scattered flock when he is with them, so I will look after my sheep. I will rescue them from all the places where they were scattered on the day of clouds and darkness. I will bring them out of the nations and gather them from the countries, and I will bring them into their own land. I will pasture them on the mountains of Israel and in the ravines and in all the settlements in the land. I will tend them in a good pasture, and the mountain heights of Israel will be their grazing land. There they will lie down in good grazing land, and there they will feed in a rich pasture on the mountains of Israel. I myself will tend my sheep and have them lie down, declares the sovereign Lord. I will search for the lost and bring back the strays. I will bind up the injured and strengthen the weak. But the sleek and the strong I will destroy. I will shepherd the flock with justice." And then later on in this passage, in verse 31, God says, "You are my sheep and the sheep of my pasture, and I am your God," declares the sovereign Lord. And do you see, even in the Old Testament, that God was painting a picture of his heart for his creation, that it's his desire that people from all places in the world would come to him, because he's searching for them. He's calling them out of darkness into his light. He's calling out the lost to be found in him. He's calling out those who are vulnerable to be protected by him. For all of us to put our trust in him alone. And so whatever you're in the middle of right now, where you're wondering who you can trust, where you're wondering where your stability can be found, where you're wondering who cares for you, would you hear today that it's Jesus, the Good Shepherd, the one who knows you, who knows his sheep, who is with you, who is for you, who is calling you to himself in every breath, in every moment, asking you, inviting you to trust him. He's not a hired hand that will run when it gets tough. He's not a hired hand who doesn't really care about his flock. He is the Good Shepherd. He is the one who laid down his life for you and who took it up again, because he cannot be defeated. He cannot be stopped. And so in him, we find our solid foundation. In him, we find our source of life. And because of him, we can stand steadfast and sure no matter what's going on around us.
Steadfast and sure, your love will endure.
We've looked at God as our shepherd and the one who cannot be stopped. And we've declared that no matter what, we find in him our firm foundation and the one in whom we can be steadfast and sure, because he is steadfast and sure. And so it seems so fitting to me that we would close with this declaration that God is good. Because if you've been invited to trust in him, we have to know that he's good, because he's trustworthy and good. And this is how we were made to live our lives. And so in that place, as we've declared him the good shepherd, let's end declaring about the goodness of God, that his goodness is chasing after you and after me, that he is always for you, loving you. His love never stops. And so let's sing together of the goodness of God and remember that he loves you. And as we know he loves us, we respond with, I love you, Jesus. I love you. And so we're going to end our time together in a way that I hope is really just the beginning for you and for me, of declaring of the goodness of God, of remembering of his goodness, no matter what's going on around us, because he is the good shepherd that doesn't leave his sheep. He is not ever going to leave you. There isn't a choice you could make after you've been found in him, where he's made you new on the inside and in the core of your being, where you've been brought into his fold. There is nothing and no one that can take you away from him. He is always loving you. He is for you. He is with you. And he is calling you. He's inviting you to live a life of trusting in him, because he is good and trustworthy and loving you. And so let's sing of the goodness of God.
I love you, Lord. Oh, your mercy never fails me. All my days I've been held in your hands. From the moment that I wake up until I lay my head, I will sing of the goodness of God. All my life you have been faithful. All my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am, I will sing of the goodness of God. I love your voice. You have led me through the fire. In darkest night, you are close like no other. I've known you as a father. I've known you as a friend, and I have lived in the goodness of God. All my life you have been faithful. All my life you have been so, so goodness.
voice is running after, it's running after me. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. Yeah. With my life laid down, I'm surrendered. Of the goodness of God. Oh, I will sing of the goodness of God.
Goodness of God.